How to stop Yorkie barking problem. Dogs often freak out at unknown people or trespassers, and that's something very normal, isn't it? Although Yorkies are amazing in their own ways and can stand to be lovely companions for anyone, it may still give concern to its owner. You guessed it right, I am talking about its long barking sessions. Before we move on with the video, I would like to say that, if you are having a hard time in training your dog with any kind of command or if your dog is suffering from any behavior problem, grab the free dog training secrets guide in which I have disclosed the deepest dog training secrets that professional dog trainers don't want you to know about. Also, you will be getting dog training videos collection in which a professional dog trainer will be guiding you with how to solve various behavioral problems in your dog absolutely free. Link to the free stuff is in the description below. Is it possible to control your Yorkie's barking behavior? Yorkies often bark out of excitement, fear, agitation as well as when it tries to communicate to someone for something. Once you find out the reason why, it will be easier for you to tame it in the right way. Just like the fact that all humans are not the same, it goes for dogs as well. This may sound to be irritating for both you as well as neighbors, at times. If you can figure out why it barks like that, you will easily be able to control its behavior likewise. Training, attention and socialization are sure to work on your pup. 1. Decode your Yorkie's barking tone. Do you speak in the same tone every time? Certainly not. If you want something, you behave politely and your tone becomes soft and low. If you are scared, your tone shivers to indicate that you are threatened. You shout out loud when you are angry, isn't it? In the same way, your pup doesn't do it either. Although Yorkshire Terriers bark more than any other breed, they too, adopt different tones in different situations. Just like you don't shout out for no reason, your dog too doesn't do it without a cause. If you truly want to train your pup and help it to stop barking, try to figure out its concerns at first. Once you are aware of what your pup is actually trying to convey, address them accordingly and it is sure to stop barking. Here are a few barking tones along with their intents. When you see your Yorkie barking at a low tone, it is probably trying to give you a notion about some sort of threat. Try finding if anything went wrong with it. If your pup is yelling at a high pitch, it is probably seeking your attention. Maybe, it is asking you to stay with it, or want to play with you. If your pup is whining, chances are there that it might be under some emotional or physical distress. Find out if your dog had any recent injury, in any case. Try to figure out what's bothering your pup and take away the suffering or pain from it if possible. When the Yorkie growls, understand that it probably didn't like something that you did to it. Did you or anyone get into its territory by any chance? It is a mark of possessiveness as well. A Yorkie generally howls at other dogs if someone gets in. You may often find that your Yorkie keeps barking on seeing a stranger and that's ridiculous. Even your friends deny coming to your house just because they are scared. Well, that's a common scenario but that's not a mandate for every pup. It all depends on the way you train the pup that assures you whether or not it will go crazy by assuming every stranger is a thief to your house. If you can train your dog really good, here's how you should start with. How to train your Yorkshire Terrier to stop barking. 1. Stop yelling at your pup. Yorkshire Terriers are small yet one of the most notorious dogs one can ever have. However, if you can train it well, things are sure to fall in their own places. Stop yelling at your pup to be quiet. First of all, it doesn't understand your language and apart from that, it seems as if you are yelling even louder than your pup. Instead, stay calm and composed. Try to make it understand your point through your gestures. Give it love and it will give it back in return. 2. Keep your sessions positive. Be compassionate to your pet. It's good to train your pup but make sure that you do not become too harsh to them. Positivity does work but application of it in reality matters. Be gentle with your pup. Talk to it, behave appropriately with it and it is sure to abide by you. 3. Be consistent in training your pup. Just like you train your kid and need to be consistent all through, you ought to do the same for your Yorkie as well. Everyone in your family should treat your dog equally, only then you will be able to train it right. If you are the only one who is training it hard and when you are away from home, your pup moves around aimlessly, you must not expect it to behave normally. 4. Reward when it performs well. Try to figure out what makes your pup bark excessively. Once you find it right, keep it away from its sight. Do not encourage your dog to continue barking for no reason. If at all, your dog gets better and listens to you, reward it so that it can improvise it for betterment. Maybe, a treat will do. 5. Supervise your pup. It is important to keep an eye on your pup. However, that doesn't mean that you should interfere in its me time. If you intervene too much, maybe, you will end up making it angry. Therefore, make sure that you do not hurt it personally or raise its ego by any chance. Keeping an eye means you should only watch it from an arm's distance without bothering it anyway. 6. Teach the quiet command to your pup. Teach your Yorkie to bark when you give him a command. Consequently, teach your dog to remain quiet on your command as well. Teach him to connect to you so that you can instruct accordingly. 7. Keep your dog engaged. A tired dog is less likely to suffer from frustration and anger. Therefore, it is usually ideal to keep it physically and mentally tired. If you do so, it won't be exposed to boredom much and thus, bark lesser. An upset pup keeps barking all the time and thus, if you don't actually want that happen, keep it busy. 8. Go for refreshments. We tame animals, but are they actually meant for doing so? Well, many a time, dogs tend to remain upset by staying inside the closed doors. Find out when it needs some doses of refreshments. Maybe, a long walk will work. You can also ask your kid to interact with it playfully or leave it to enjoy among other dogs for some time. These things do help a lot. 9. Socialize your dog. A dog that is capable of interacting with people will surely grow up to be a good pup than someone who doesn't interact much. The latter one is thus expected to bark at guests coming to your home, for they are new faces for it. Hence, it is essential to understand the significance of socializing your dog so that it remains habituated with meeting new people and not being over-possessive about the same. Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe to the Little Paws Training channel if you are serious about training and grooming your dog. Grab the free dog training videos and ebook from the link in description so that you don't have to spend hours in training your dog. Train your dog in a smarter way. Also, join the Facebook group where you get all the solutions to your daily doggy problems. Your text here.